I have the privilege and I have the pleasure of bringing up someone who me and my wife, we just fell in love with her. We just fell in love with her. She's a mother, she's a grandmother. She's an entrepreneur, and she has taken this movement and put it on her back. And what she's doing is she's sharing with so many people to make the movement possible, to make people, to change people's lives. So I'm going to step out the way of greatness. Hold on, what? Real quick. If you got a cell phone, everybody got cell phones? Take that cell phone and put it on vibrate or turn it off. Okay, because you don't want to miss any other information. None of it. Nair, none of it. Nair. Not near none of it. Okay? You don't want to miss none of it. Okay? The restrooms. What did I say again? Help me out. 35 steps. Not like this, but 35 steps from that door all the way that way. Y'all know what that way is?
Right.
That way. It's that way right there. 35 steps. So, without further ado, I want to bring up in front of the room, Miss Phyllis Latham.
Forgive me, I want to give you an apology first because I slid in here. But I want to make up for that by just letting you know how much we appreciate you for coming out, taking your time out on a Saturday just to come out here. But I too am going to get away from greatness right now. A little bit about myself before I introduce her. My name is Phyllis Latham. I was born in Grand Rapids, Michigan, raised in Sweetwater, Tennessee, itty-bitty little town. So I got a lot of my southern ways from my family down there. But, okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay, I need to speak a little higher. But anywho, I came up here right after my children graduated. I had been through a divorce and was just trying to find a new way to find myself, so to speak. And I got introduced to BYOB by this wonderful person here who took me under his wing and was just like a big brother to me. Him and his wife has just been so wonderful in teaching me the basics on, you know, Forex. But before I go into that, I have that to talk to you about later. I want to introduce you to a mentor, a beautiful woman of God. She too has took me under her wing and has, oh my gosh, just soared. And she just put, how can I put this, she has put the top of the cherry on the ice cream, put it that way. Wonderful, wonderful woman, knows a lot of knowledge and wants to talk to you a little bit more about BYOB. So without further ado, I am gonna introduce Miss Elizabeth Reed. Come on, Elizabeth.
Introduction. In fact, I was kind of looking around to see who in the world is talking. I want to start out with a disclaimer. As I stand here before you, if I just burst out in tears, I want you to know that they're tears of joy. And the reason they're tears of joy is because as you sit right here, you're an answer to prayer. You are an answer, literally a dream come true. And I'm talking about not just a dream, but I'm talking about progressive dreams. What am I talking about? I happen to be with Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. back in Washington, D.C., when he marched on Washington. I was there to hear him say, "I have a dream." Part of that dream was that men and women would not be judged by the color of their skin,
yeah,
but by the character, the content of their character. That was a part of the dream. And then 4 years ago, Mr. Gerald Rogers and Miss Tasha Dyer sat in a Panera Bread and dreamed that you would be here, along with 2 million people all over the globe for this mighty movement. I had the audacity back in December, I think it was December, we went to an expo in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And when I returned from that expo, I had a dream. I said, they can't just do it in Milwaukee. We're going to do it in Cleveland. No, we're going to put Cleveland on the map. All right. Yeah. And so now, Dr. Martin Luther King's dream, Mr. Rogers and Miss Dyer's dream, and my dream, that's why I said it's progressive, have all come true. They got flesh and blood and skin on the dream. Come on, somebody. Yes. Here we are in living color. So all I got to say, put your right hand up,
all right.
Put your left hand up, and put them together. And turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, we are a dream come true.
We are a dream come true.
Oh, my God. Now, I understand. You came here looking to see our trade whisperer, Miss Dyer. And she sends her regrets because she was not able to be here. Her father was hospitalized, and we know how important family is. And we, you know, as much as she wanted to be here, we insisted that she be at home in Jacksonville, Florida. So you got to put up with me.
That's okay.
Like the worst thing that ever happened to you. But I am so excited about being here to talk about the greatest economic empowerment movement known to mankind. And before I go any further, I need to tell you just a little bit about me. Some of you who know the inner city of Cleveland may know 71st Street between Quincy and between Central and Cedar. That's where I was raised, and then on to the project at East 40th and Woodland. My mother and my father both were hospitalized, and my dad died while they were hospitalized. So I never really got a chance to say goodbye to my dad. I was only 7 years old. Raised in a project, single mother who was too sick to work, too ill to work. So we were raised on aid for dependent children, if you know what that means. She couldn't work, so they gave us what they thought we needed for 4 children and a mother. I went on to school and did what most of us were taught to do, go to college, get a good education, earn a lot of money, retire, you know. Well, I did go to school. I went to college, got an early degree. Somebody may know I had to name my early degree Damon.
Okay.
So you may know what I'm talking about. Now, here I am, a single mother, trying to raise a child that I had at 19. I didn't know what I was doing. But I had got a good job. Never had to look for a job. Somebody always came and told me, hey, we need you here. And went to the telephone company, worked at the telephone company for 33 and a half years, and even had 2 jobs at one time. I worked for the government, and I worked for the government for over 10 years and retired from both of those careers and thought, oh, I got it going on now. And I wasn't retired a whole year. I went to work for the church and worked for the church. I was only going to work for 2 months at the church. Wound up working 23 and a half years at the church as a receptionist. And still, I retired broke. If anybody can identify with that, you know exactly what I mean. I needed a way out. Well, through a crisis in my life, and I won't go into that detail right now, but just prior to the pandemic, I had a crisis in my life, and my mentor introduced me to BYOB. She was reluctant about it because she had just joined, and she felt maybe we better wait until she had mastered this plan. And as I got ready to leave her house one evening, she said, no, wait a minute. I think we need to learn this thing together. And I tell you, that was one of those, well, the second best thing that she could have done for me, because the first best thing she did for me, she insisted that I call a gentleman who had just had a severe loss in his life. And I kept saying, I'm not calling him. She insisted that I call him. Well, I want you to know he's sitting back there, and almost 6 months ago, I became his wife. The first thing she did was insist that I call Dr. Reed. And the second best was that she introduced me to BYOB. And that's why I stand here. I qualify to stand before you and tell you about this movement. I tell you, I am so, I ask the young people, and when I say if I tear up, please look over that and know that these are tears of joy. I ask the young people, I say, you have a saying. Can I use your saying? And they said, what is it? I said, jacked out of my mind, because I'm jacked out of my mind. This is the greatest thing that has ever happened to me. And what we have before us in this movement, the opportunity to learn, and it's been simplified. It is so simple that we literally have a little 7-year-old that's been trading for 3 years now. And the way her mother punishes her is she'll say, can we look at the market? Can we look at the charts? And her mother says, she hasn't behaved. No, you can't look at the chart. Can you imagine that having been your punishment at 7 years old, that you couldn't look at a chart? We didn't know what trading was all about, did we? So simple that even a 21-year-old, I get excited, I get God pimples when I think about this 21-year-old who learned this trade, and in 1 year, he started out with $500, and he's now a 7-figure earner in trading. Come on, I'm talking about this. And how simple this opportunity is. Now, when we look at it, there are... It angers me when I think about the fact that 95% of the earnings are monies are controlled by 5% of the people. And what you're here today to learn how to move from that 95% to the 5% that control all the money. As we see here on this graph, 60% of the money is earned by people who work for somebody else, you know? And I heard one of our partners say she was in job jail. That's what we're here for, to get you out of job jail, those of you that are in job jail. And then 35% work for themselves. And anybody, and you know what I'm talking about. When you work for yourself, it only means that you've got several jobs, okay? Because you got to do it all. And then we have only 4% are business owners, okay? And a mere 1% are investors. And I want you to know that investment is about a mindset. And this is what we're here for, to help you change your mind. So what if there was another way? That's a silly question. I come to tell you there is another way. BYOB is the way out of job jail and a way to financial freedom. And if I said to you what you say to you, would I be your best friend? Think about it. We don't realize how much we talk to ourselves. But we talk to ourselves all day long.
Yes.
I wondered what would happen if what you're saying to yourself right now would flash on the screen. Wouldn't that be amazing?
Yeah.
You know, and I won't even think about some of the things that you might be saying just about now. But we got to be careful what we say to ourselves, because what you say becomes what you do, and what you do becomes who you are. Isn't that amazing? Not just you, but me too. Come on. Our story is simple. We empower people. We don't just do things for you, but we empower you so you can do it, and empower people. So that's how this movement is growing. Empower people. What else? Our story is so simple that we build better lives. And I'm a witness. You know, it's about making money, and I love money. You didn't tell you that, I love money. Ooh, the Bible says that the love of money is the root of all evil. Let me back that up. I love what money can do for me. All right, that makes a difference. I love what money does for me. I can now give more money to my church. I can do more money to the things that are most important to me. And I'm in a place where my family is going to put my picture on the mantle, and I'm going to be the one that changes the trajectory of my family, and you can do exactly the same thing. So that's what I'm talking about, building better lives. We also give meaning and purpose to the success rate that I have seen. We've got a 92% sense of success. Ooh, success. That you find with this movement, that we make our everything that comes out of our mouth is positive. And I, if you're in my presence anytime, you aren't going to say anything negative because I'm not going to hear it. And we take every time a negative thought or a negative word comes out of our mouth, then we replace it with two positive thoughts or two positive sayings, okay? And that's finding success starts within. It's not an outside in, but it's an inside out job. Isn't that awesome? Now, how would you feel if you had complete control? The banks weren't controlling your money. And that's what we want to talk about, is the banks can how they control our money. So have you ever heard that about the exchange market? It's blowing my mind, I tell you. The fact that here we have the opportunity to learn about the chain, the exchange market. And here, I don't even remember hearing the word trillion. I said with a D. I didn't say million, I didn't say billion, I said trillion. There are trillions of dollars.
Bless you.
How many zeros in a trillion? More than you have in your telephone number. Come on, 12 zeros in trillions. Can you just wrap your head around and just imagine $6.6 trillion? And that's not a week, that's not a month, a day is actually being exchanged. Can you imagine that? Oh, come on, somebody. Can you imagine that as much of that $6.6 trillion a day is available to each and every one of you, and it's about your work ethic and how much time you're willing to put into it? Come on, that's available to us every day. Now, the market's open 5 days a week, 24 hours, so around your schedule, so you can fit your schedule into your trading time in this foreign market. Oh my God, without owning any physical money. See, there's a difference. When you're investing in the market, you put up a certain amount of money, you buy a certain commodity, stock, gold, whatever, oil. You buy that, and then you sit and watch and wait because you want the value to go up so that you earn some money.
Right.
Not so with trading, with the BYOB movement. This is what you do. We learn how to read the charts so that when the market goes up, we make money. And when the market comes down, we make money. When the market goes up, and we learn how to read the chart. Like I told you, a six-year-old can not only do it, but she can teach it better than I can. And then an 86-year-old can also do it. So I know you're somewhere in between 6 and 86. So if you can read and you can count, you can certainly trade. Well, we want to welcome you to the Foreign Exchange, FRX. That's what this is all about. And you're going to hear more about that in a moment. Whew. Now, there's another market that's growing toward $3.3 trillion in addition to the $6.6 trillion. We're setting the future stage for how everyone will handle money. In fact, there's a gentleman in this room. He didn't do quite what Oprah did, because back in 2019, Oprah actually invested $100 million in the Bitcoin coin platform, all right? That's in the digital coin market. Well, we got a gentleman, and I ain't gonna point him out, he don't have to raise his hand, but he's sitting right here in the room with us. 2016, this gentleman got interested in Bitcoin. He couldn't find anybody that would explain to him about this digital system. So he did a lot of research himself. And he found a machine, an ATM machine, where he could literally take $600 and invested it in the digital coin market, invested it in Bitcoin. That $600 that he invested in 2016, that money went up to, I think, $62,000 at one point, and at this point, it's now worth $36,000. Come on, from $600 to $36,000. And that's what's available to us. Oh, you can do better than that. That was just a little patty cake. Come on. Several years back, he proposed creating the actual digital currency to as a pay system so they could pay. But right here in Ohio, we were the first state that actually set up digital currency for payment to our employees. And yeah, that I mean, so we're on the map. We're already on the map as far as this digital currency. So, but we have the opportunity to get in on the ground floor. And the thing that blows my mind, I forgot to tell you, and I don't think Phyllis told you, but you know what, I'm just only 85 years young. And to be 85 years young, and to be able to learn this digital currency, you know, if I had known this, when I was your age, my God, I don't know where I'd be today. But the fact that I have the privilege not only to learn it, but to know all about it, this is amazing, I tell you. So becoming global forms of money, I tell you. So everyday purchases, they tell me, I don't like Starbucks. Anybody? I can't see paying $6 and $7 for a cup of coffee, especially when I get some free when I can. So now, but at Starbucks, there are some Starbucks where you can actually pay for your coffee with Bitcoin, with digital coins. Yeah, you'll find, and just watch as you go around, drive through the city, you're gonna see more and more ATM machines where you can actually trade and you can actually purchase Bitcoins and other coin. It's amazing, I tell you. We're in for that. So you can also trade without having any money at all. And I talked about that a little bit. Digital currency. And then the thing about this movement that's so great. Karen, hold up that little device there sitting on there. Just hold it up. Everybody, the babies have cell phones, okay? I don't understand that, but these babies understand cell phone far better than I do. So they set it up so we can learn and earn as we go and on the go. Because here we can literally download our academy onto your cell phone. And as you're traveling, you can actually have the opportunity to learn. I love this. This movement is so great. And the platform that we use is IM Academy. And I love what they said. Choose your weapon. Oh yeah, it's a weapon of warfare. And I feel war every time I see that and I think about it. Because we got a war against poverty. Yeah. Yeah. We got a war against lack. Come on. And I got so sick and tired of hearing my mother say, well, we ain't got enough for that. We can't do that. Well, we don't have to tell our children that anymore. This opportunity, this great movement has erased all of the excuses. That's why they call me the excuse eraser. Because if I can do it at 85 years young, if I can stand here and tell you about this great movement, if it's changing my life at this point in my life, changing my husband's life at 86 years young, then come on, you know we can change the world and turn this world upside right. It's already been turned upside down. We don't turn it upside right. So here in the academy, every tool that you need to learn this trading is here and available for you. And who makes it available? BYOB. Be your own bank movement. I'll tell you a little bit about be your own bank. We were on a call yesterday. Carol and I were on a call with women on yesterday. And Carol talked about Clubhouse. I don't know much about Clubhouse. But she got on Clubhouse with the millennials. And they were talking about the bank system. And the point that Carol made is that millennials think so different than we as seasoned folk think, okay? You know, you see a lot of gray hair. We earn it. Keep on living and you'll earn something too. So now, what happened is they said they never trusted the banks. Carol, as a seasoned individual, said, she never would have said that. She just takes her money, puts it in the bank, and she's satisfied with that, that they're gonna do what they should with our money when we put it in the bank. Well, what BYOB, I just wanna take you on a little trip. When I grew up back in 40th and Woodland, at the corner of 55th and Woodland, where Kinsman and Woodland and Buckeye intersect there, there used to sit a bank called Cleveland Trust Bank. Cleveland Trust Bank was in our neighborhood, but it wouldn't lend any money to any of us in the neighborhood. And when they started lending money to us, they only would lend you money to buy a used automobile. Couldn't buy homes like you get. Like the homes you have, Wayne. And so here, then I saw that, a point where we can't have loans, we can't get loans. And then it moved to credit cards, debit cards. A lot of folk got upset, said, that's of the devil. I don't use no credit card. And now those are the people that got 5 or 6, 7 credit cards. Because we didn't have a choice. We couldn't do anything about it. So then we moved to an era where we're now, they've given us so much credit until we're over our head in credit.
Right.
And we will never, ooh, that brings another thought. I'll take care of that in a minute. Then we move to that. But oh my God, we got a chance to get on the other side of money now. We've come from they wouldn't lend us any money until they overextended, allowed us to overextend ourselves. And now here I am on this side over here with you, on the other side of money, where I can be my own bank. Come on, somebody. Yeah. The same thing that the bank's been doing with our money forever. Be your own bank. The greatest, the largest economic empowerment movement known to mankind. And I tell you, this foreign exchange master, you can master this academy. I'm just so excited because we have a chance to be on the move. And as I told you when I started, two people, Mr. Gerald D. Rogers and Ms. Tasha M. Dyer, who, again, for those that came late, sends her apology because her dad was hospitalized and she couldn't be with us this morning. They sat in Panera Bread in Jacksonville, Florida, and saw every one of us along with the rest that make up this 2 million households. Mr. Rogers, as a child, was given a charge by his grandmother. First of all, she was a woman of God, and she anointed him every day with oil. She taught him how to read from the book of Psalms and the word of God. And he grew up, he's a man of God. He's a minister of the gospel. But he's the founder of this great movement because she gave him a charge just before she passed. You set your family financially free. He said, you're not employed by this bank system for naught, but I want you to take everything that you've learned and make sure that you see to it that your family is free. Well, he wasn't satisfied with me, my foe, and no more. And he had us in mind. We didn't have faces and names at the time, but when they sat in Panera Bread and she agreed with him, we're gonna see this movement be 2 million plus strong. Now, he was a business, he's a business success coach. He's also been in mortgage lending in the bank, both on the residential side and the commercial lending side. So he knows what he's talking about. He's been an investment banker for over 26 years, and he's also a real estate developer. So I would say that he had the right to have a dream, and I'm so glad that he didn't keep it to himself, that he included us in that dream. And then Ms. Dyer, she's something else. I call her a Wonder Woman. That's who she is. Because this woman, she's a mother, she's a grandmother, she has both these little kids running around, and she takes such good care of them. Being a co-founder, we call her the Trade Whisperer, because she's the one that developed this simple strategy where we can trade and make one trade a day and literally work our way to wealth that we never, ever imagined. And she was a retired major from the United States Army. She's also been voted the Clay County Officer of the Year. She not only has one MBA, but she was awarded two MBAs. And I tell you, she just has a heart of gold. She makes sure that we know she's invested so much into our lives so that we can be as successful as she and Mr. Rogers are. So what do we have? Access to over 100 full-time educators in this platform that the BYOB movement uses. Now, you know, I used to think it was real funny when they said leaders work themselves out of a job, okay? Leaders train leaders so that they can replace themselves. And that's just what Mr. Rogers and Ms. Dyer have done. We have our second generation of educators. in the person of Ms. Bradley, Mrs. Anderson, that's my mentor, Mrs. Anderson, Ms. Perry, and Pastor Washington. And we just says that they come from all walks of life. We have business owners. Ms. Anderson has been featured in the Success From Home magazine over 10 times in a row. I mean, I'm talking about people that know what they're doing in this industry. And then we have a third, did you get your picture, dear?
Yes, thank
you. Okay, third generation of educators, businesswoman. We have a gentleman who was responsible for starting up over 200 restaurants, chain of restaurants. And then Ms. Graham is all the way from London, England, and she's one of our trainers, excellent trainer. And then we have Ms. Turner, who is a businesswoman, works for one of the top companies. And then we have a gentleman, we call him the blue collar baller, because he loves to ball, and he's a trainer personified. And now what are you talking about? Third generation. Because see, there's a fourth generation, a fifth generation, a sixth generation, and I believe they're sitting right here in this room, some of them, training that are going to be training. Oh my God, I see it. You just don't know what God has planned for you for tomorrow. All you know is you sit here today, but you don't know what's coming tomorrow.
Right.
Okay, and then, we have our own radio broadcast. It's called Hidden in Plain Sight, because this movement, this opportunity, the fact that we can be our own, has literally been hidden, was right in our face, but it was hidden from us, kept from us. None of us grew up thinking, ooh, I'm gonna be my own bank. Ooh, I'm gonna learn how to trade. I didn't even know anything about, yes, I did. Let me tell you what I knew about trading. This is what I knew. I knew that my granddaddy and my auntie and my uncle ran numbers. Anybody? And the policy. Would be betting on this little money, and they come by every evening to collect the money, and if we match what the stock market ended with, then we win. Come on, the young folks, you don't know what I'm talking about. But that's all I knew about numbers then. And here, now, I'm my own bank, my God. So we're bridging the gap. We've got our founder and our co-founder, and I mean, this is my grandbaby, y'all. She claimed me as her BYOB grandmama. And we are so much alike, it's unbelievable. And then this gentleman is a recording artist, and you're gonna hear from him a little later. And I tell you, I'm so grateful. Every Tuesday at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, you can find us on rejoice904.com, or you can find us on Facebook, our own radio broadcast. Now let me tell you something. Mm-hmm. Somebody probably sitting here there, I'm going to search this thing out. I'm going on the internet and I'm going to find out about it. Well, I want you to know you can't do no better searching than MasterCard Company can. MasterCard searched us out, and MasterCard has now allowed us to have our own branded prepaid debit card. Oh, debit card that I know of, can you earn money spending your own money? But you literally get cash back, and you don't have to be a member of BYOB to have this debit card. Anybody can apply for this debit card and get cash back. Isn't that wonderful? And so here we are. I forgot to tell you, our co-founder and our founder literally published the book, Be Your Own Bank, Hidden in Plain Sight. And the book is available on Amazon or on our website. You gotta get this book, because it talks about the movement and where they came from and where we're headed in this movement. Oh, I tell you, now, it says, I am ready. And I know everybody in this room is ready. Ready to, I'm gonna do it one more time. All the way over here on this side, on the side where you got to worry. Well, I can't have this, I can't have that, I can't do this, I ain't got enough money. My mother used to say to me, what do you think? I'm going to chew some green paper and money up. That's what I used to hear when I was growing up. And now we got the opportunity to move all the way to the other side of money, where we have abundance and plenty. You can give to anybody you want to. You can bless the not-haves with what you have. You can give more to your church, to your synagogue, to your mom, to whatever you can. That what really makes you go, your heart go tick-tock, tick-tock. That's what you can give to when you become a member and enroll in this wonderful opportunity, in this learning platform. The elite package that supplies everything that you need is only $325 as your startup enrollment. And then your monthly package is only $274 for the elite package. Now, when I think about it, let me tell you what makes me angry. I used to have a favorite emotion, used to be anger. And I tell people, I'm getting angry now, boy. Watch out, getting angry now. And every time I think about it, I just talked to one of my partners yesterday that couldn't be here this morning. She's over 60 years old, and she's still paying off her student loan. Come on, I know somebody that's 70 that's still paying off the student loan. The system has it so set up until you can never pay off your student loan. I know of another situation where the young lady is a senior in high school, and just next month, in May, she'll be graduating from high school. She's going to college. They offered her a whole $1,000 toward her education and a loan to take care of the rest of the education. Her mama, not her mother, her mama is still paying off her student loan. And they want her to take out another student loan for the daughter. Is this system crazy?
Yes.
Well, here we are. We have the solution to every problem. The crime, the poverty, the hunger. We got the solution right here. And when you think about what you had to pay for your college degree, what some of you may be paying even right now, and what are you learning? Huh? You're learning how to be somebody else's dream.
No.
You are not learning. They don't teach us how to be a dreamer and to fulfill our own dreams. They don't teach us how to be our own man. Do you have, how many of you have been to college or in college? Anybody? Come on. Raise your hand up high. Come on. Put it up high. How many of you learned how to be your own bank? How many of you learned that you could trade on the foreign market and you spent all that money? Whew. This is nothing. This is peanuts compared to that. And yet, this will change your life forever. Forever. So, you can become an independent business owner too. You don't have to, but that's an opportunity that's afforded to you once you enroll in the in this learning in the IM Academy. You can become a business owner. Now, when we think about it, there's a success rate in BYOB of 100% if you apply yourself. Down here, you start out, oh my God, I don't know what's going on. And it's not that it's difficult, it's just different.
It's different.
It's different than anything we've ever seen in our life. And so when you first started school, you didn't know anything about ABCs. You didn't know how to count 1, 2, 3. It took time to learn it. And that's how easy this is, ABC, 1, 2, 3. But as we continue up the scale, because of the training that's available in BYOB, we not only have the academy that's available to us online 24/7, we also have 40 hours every week of training that's available to us. We have our educators who are so much concerned about our success that they just pour into our lives. I've never seen anything like it in my life. And the only reason you would fail is because of you. You are destined to be a winner if you stick with us and stay plugged in, all right? Now, whew, this blew my mind. Here you see a rate of pay for the different banks. Wells Fargo pays a senior trader $155,270 a year. And they send them to school, learn how to trade. You spend a fortune for your education, and you go there 4 years, sometimes six. You come out, and then you get a job at Wells Fargo to be their trader. Now, if Wells Fargo is going to pay you $155,000 to trade, they got to be making some money to pay that kind of money for you to trade. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Whose money is paying them? Your money and my money. And they're giving us what? Peanuts. So that says, here, what they're spending 6 years, 4 to 6 years learning to then have to be trained and then make that kind of money. We get it, and in less than a year, we can make more money than they're making here. There's no guarantee because it's up to you. What you invest, what you put into it is what you get out of it. But that just gives some idea that this is what the banks are paying. When you go into a city, I encourage you, just go downtown Cleveland, downtown, any city you go into. Going out downtown in that city, Chicago, San Francisco, LA, and look up. And when you look up, the tallest buildings in every city are owned by the banks. Your money, building those buildings. So you get to build your own life. Come on, you get to change your life as a result of this movement. BYOB, be your own bank. The greatest economic empowerment movement known to mankind. An opportunity. And I'm not just talking about an opportunity, and I'm not just talking about a company, but I'm talking about a movement. And I'm going to come back after our break, and I'm going to tell you about this movement, because, you know, it's been hard for me to stand still. It really has. Because I get the glad glance every time I think about this, that God had me in mind when he said, the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the just.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
The wealth of the wicked is laid up for the just. And if you count yourself as J-U-S-T, just, baby, it's for you. This is phenomenal. We're going to take this a 10-minute break. And any of you who is as glad as I am that we've been counted in the number and you're ready to enroll, whoever invited you is ready to enroll you in the academy. And the sweet thing about this academy is the fact that you're not under contract, and anytime you want to, you can get out. But I don't know very many people that won't out because it's so powerful. And here, oh, I'm going to do it one more time as we close. Out the door. That's where we were as far as money is concerned. Lack, poverty, need more, want more, can't have it. You we just ain't got it. And we get the opportunity to strut. We don't have to just tiptoe, but we get a chance to strut all the way to the other side of money.
Yes.
Come on, anybody want to go with me? We're on our way to the other side of money, and we're going to break for 10 minutes, and there's going to be the greatest decision that you can make in your life is to become a part of this movement and enroll in the academy. God bless you. Thanks for your time.